My last video was like 6 days ago, 7 days ago. I want to be consistent. So I asked my family and friends on Facebook and Instagram to send me some questions so I can do a Q&A. So the first one is from Xavier. What's up, bro? Did you ever get dreads? And if I did, I would look like a whole snack. I would definitely get dreads. I did faux locs before and I like that style. But it was just really heavy on my head. It started hurting my neck. And once I feel like my neck is uncomfortable, like the whole style just needs to get thrown away. So I might do dreads again, but like a shorter length where it's comfortable for me. But thanks for that question, bro. The next one's from my girl Pilar. What's up, Pilar? She said, what have you learned about yourself in the last year? I learned that I was able to develop patience. I never had patience before. I still actually don't have patience. I'm not like...
Breathe in and breathe out.
I still flip out from time to time. I'm not even gonna lie. But I've learned to be patient and I learned to forgive people because they don't know what they're doing. And I picked that up in the Bible. So it actually helped me to just be patient, accept people's journeys and how they respond to their journey, to just better myself so I could be better to the next person. Of course, I'm human. I'm gonna mess up. I have messed up. As long as I keep trying, right? I like that question though. That made me like really reflect on myself and made me think. So kudos to you, girl. The next one's from Angie. What's up, baby girl? Angie asked, if you can go back to high school, what is one thing you would change or take back? Definitely, I think about this all the time and it pisses me off. I would get better grades so I could stay on a volleyball team. When I got kicked off the volleyball team,
they ask you how you are and you just have to say that you're fine.
That hurt my feelings. I was super, super upset because I love volleyball. You don't understand, that was like my go-to. Every time there was gym class, if you know me and you had gym with me in high school in Hartford High, you'd know that the first thing I always did was play volleyball. I loved volleyball. Volleyball was so fun. So when I finally got on the team, I think her name was Miss Turcotte. I can't remember. When I, you know, I had practice and everything. I had practice for like 2 weeks. And then we were gonna have our first scrimmage against Weathersfield. And the day before the scrimmage, oh my God. She pulled me to the side and she said, what is this? Like, what's up? You don't have enough credits to even like be on a volleyball team. And I was just like,
dang, man, so I can't be on the team.
She was just
like, no, and you're good too. I don't know what happened, but I'm sorry.
I was just like, wow, that was a slap in the face because your girl would have been on a volleyball team, officially. Next question is from a girl I just met. Her name's Nairo, and she does nails and custom press-ons. And she's local from my city, Hartford. What's up, girl? She asked me a really good question. I like this question because it definitely has been something that's been pondering on my mind a lot. How do you balance on a day-to-day with being a mom, doing YouTube, and working out, and other hobbies? Now, one of those hobbies I actually dropped. I haven't spoken to you guys about it because it's been weighing on me a lot. I actually stopped working out. I stopped eating healthy, but I still stay on. I try to stay on my water. I feel like I sort of gave up on myself and I needed that motivation back. I kind of found motivation, but not really with YouTube. YouTube is more than just doing a video, uploading it, and just hoping people bump into it and see it. You have to actually promote yourself, and you know promoting takes a lot of hustle. So you gotta really think and be creative and have fun with YouTube, but also keep in mind that, you know, you have to put work into it if you really want to succeed in it. Now, with being a mom, usually I do the videos. I try to do the videos as early as possible. My son will be sleeping in the bed. Like, I was trying to record earlier when he was sleeping and he woke up, so now he's in the other room. But most of the time, he's in the room quiet, or if he gets too loud, I'll be like, no, you gotta get out. I try to do, like, a schedule. Like, I'll wake up, I'll tidy up my room, I'll do my YouTube homework. I call it my YouTube homework if I bump into it on my Facebook groups. I try to fight how I feel, because if I'm feeling really down that day, I will not post on social media. I won't post no pictures. It really... I'm still trying to find a balance for it, but I feel like what I've been doing the past week has been helping. I haven't been on YouTube, so this is my first video while incorporating into the routine that I've been doing to mentally prep myself, because she did say that when she does something, she puts her all in one thing. And I do the same thing, but I want to be able to be versatile and not put all of my eggs in one basket. And that is harder than it's harder than it said. So Nairo, I know what you're talking about, girl. So my next question is from Choose God Every Time. By the way, the information will be in the description box and the merch. What's up, Jessica? I love this. I love this merch. Go check it out. They got hoodies, dad hats, shirts. They got a tie-dye shirt that says, God took his time with me. I can't wait to get that. I don't know if y'all heard that, but that's my son in the background. See? Trying to balance. How has your past relate to your glow and your YouTube page? That is a very, very deep question. So, as I get more with you guys, I do want to get more open and personal. Like, my past has, everyone has a past. Everyone has pain and hurt that they've been through. I recently just, like, went through something, and that really just, if you know, you know. But that just, like, kind of put a light bulb in my head. Like, I need to get my shit together, and I need to focus on me. And that's been... That's why I've been kind of going hard with YouTube, because I feel like I owe it all to myself. I've been my own worst enemy for a very long time. I always told myself that I can't do nothing. I was a bum. You know, just saying that shit to yourself, it kind of weighs you down. So I decided to just get it together. I got it together. I'm glad I got it together. I'm still kind of messed up. You know, I still have my down days. I'm still human. It's gonna happen. But as long as I keep pushing forward, it feels good to see that I'm pushing forward. So my YouTube is helping me, like, it's allowing me to blossom in front of you guys and with you guys. If you're on a journey too where you want to blossom, it just feels good to be able to glow up and not be afraid to glow up, because I used to be afraid to be beautiful. I don't know why. I had a lot of issues. Don't ask. Okay, so I can't say his name because he asked me this question on Instagram. I actually never learned his real name, but he's always been supportive. He asked me this question. When we going on our date? I just know you off Instagram, so I can't go on a date with you. But I do want to shout you out for always supporting me. You always support me. And that does not go unnoticed. And I always let you know that. So don't be mad at the answer. I'm being real with you. I just know you from Instagram. But you're one of those people that always supported me no matter what. And you pushed me. So, yeah. And the last question is from my mommy. My mom said that she sees a lot of the videos that I do, and what do I do to help inspire the next? I purposely promote myself and push myself because I know someone out there will see it. And I want people to see that hustle, and I want them to be able to tap into their calling, because I know a bunch of people have a calling. Everyone has a calling, not a bunch, sorry. Everyone has a calling. It's just up to them to get out of that fear. I want to help people get out of that fear and to really go after their dreams, because I do not want you guys to be 70 and 80, you know, like, just regretting every, like, I don't want us to be 80 and be like, man, when I was in my late 28s or 30s, I wish I would have done what I wanted to do. Because it's like, you can't, you have to make it happen. As I'm 28 right now, you know, I'm gonna be 30, 35 soon, and I wanna be able to look back at this age and be proud of myself for taking the leap of faith that I did. Because I know if I do, well, I know that I am taking the leap of faith, it's gonna get me to where I want to go. And I'm speaking into existence. A lot of people say they are scared to speak, like, their dreams and stuff out loud because of, like, a bad eye. And I understand that. But personally, whatever God has planned for you, no man can ruin. Nothing can stop it. He's powerful. So it's like, I can't fear what was, like, meant for me, you know? I can only just build myself up to get there. And I hope that you can do it too. And here I go being emotional. But I really did enjoy these questions. I know it was a quick Q&A. I really appreciate you guys for sitting. If you made it this far, thanks. I know I'm pretty boring. I don't have a life, so. I am currently on the road to 1K. The road to 1K subscribers. And I'm so excited. This is a long journey. Alright guys, if you like, comment, and subscribe. And your girl is out. Peace.